Hello everyone, welcome back to another episode of the Direwolf20 back. So, I haven't built a house yet, I also haven't uploaded the first episode yet when I'm recording it. I really felt like recording. So, I've done some mining. I feel like I've done pretty good, like 25 diamonds, you know? You know? That's in my book, that's pretty darn good. Also, I went back to the village and collected everything. Also, if anything seems odd about the stuff I have, like I'm missing something, when I reloaded the world, everything was as if I've never been here. Like, the world, like, it didn't save at all. Only my location was saved, so I died. Should probably remove those waypoints now. Yeah, like this one. This one's from when I loaded up the world, it just kind of killed me. So yeah, so like you see, I have a pretty decent amount of iron. And well, I just think it's time to work on some fun stuff. Well, first off, I want to double my ores, because, you know, one stack of iron is good, but two stacks are better. One way to do this is through Tinkerer's Construct. I should grab my food. Also got some witchery books out of the village, I found them there. So, okay, I need 3 sticks. Two for a shovel and one for the sword. Okay, because, yeah, I want to be armed. Wait, okay, no, it's not night yet. So, I'm gonna make a smeltery. I already have a lot of seared bricks. However, I just want a bit more. So what I'll need is half a stack of gravel, already have like 31, half a stack of sand and half a stack of clay. Okay, so I only need clay. And clay is of course found in rivers, it's pretty common. Oh, you'd have to die for it, which kind of smells. We do gather it quickly. So now I have half a stack of all the things I need. Let's get back to the base. Or floor, I guess. Crown. Yeah, I don't really have a base, do I? It's just a couple of chests, furnaces, a craft table, and a bed. There are no walls for floor. So yeah. I really, really need those suggestions in order to make make a base in general. So, I'm gonna need this and this. Now, why I needed the gravel sand, if you never work things construct, this is how you make grout. Grout is a pretty, well, it's actually the main thing you need for smelteries. Like this, and you're cooking seared bricks. I actually need more sand, because I'm going to need glass. Sand's a pretty good resource to have in general, so... Yeah. Okay, this should do for a while. I don't know, I'm gonna go for half stack. So I just need a bit more. Here. 1, 2, 3. Oh crap, I have to get to my bed, because I cannot end them off right now. I don't even have armor. I only have sword. I've still one iron eight. Okay. Because at some point I had to make an iron pick while mining, so yeah. So okay. Anyway. Now it's just waiting. Well, while waiting for that to cook up, I'm gonna choose a place. I'm gonna say right here sometimes, right? I make a sickle to clear away the grass. I actually already made one, that's why the ground here is so clear. Alright, I've closed my inventory. Okay, I should turn down my sound. It sounded pretty loud to me, and yeah. Okay, so this is how you make a sickle. I didn't do it on camera just because I didn't think it that important, but this is all it does. It breaks more than one grass for you, so you can actually clear out an area rather quickly. Without having to just throw around water buckets everywhere. So let's make a smeltery. So you start out by making a 3x3 hole, or bigger if you want to. I believe that's like a new function. You can actually just go with like a 10x10 for the smeltery. You know what? I'm going to. Oh, I actually want to try that once. I've never done that, so. Great, the lag kind of made me smash a hole in the ground. Okay. So remember, of course, how bigger you make it, the more expensive it gets. So a smeltery is pretty much sort of a multi-block structure, which will let you double your ores. Easy, right? Yeah, that's pretty much all you need to know about it. It's really easy to use, easy to figure out, and well, it's just an easy thing to use in general. Well, let's grab some of these and some of these. So the first thing you would want to make for smeltery normally, because I already had these things so I didn't make them, is the controller. The controller is pretty much the brains of an operation. Yeah, you see brain at the smeltery. And you would want a seared tank. I usually make two, so I can make it symmetrical, and I like symmetry. So the smelting may take that. Take a bite. It may take a bite out of, yeah. Okay, so you just place it down like this. You see it not do anything right now. That's because it's an invalid structure. That is right, because the smeltery has to be closed. Okay, like this, boom, controller. No, I'm an idiot. Okay, you know what, I'll be back once this is all. Oh, by the way, while walking to my base, I saw that weird structure over there. I'm not sure what it is, but you know what, after I get armor, I'll explore it. Possibly with you guys. Probably. You know what, with you guys. Okay, so I decided to build a little further already, off-cam, but... Okay, so now I'm going to build a new part. I'm going to build two drains. What these drains do is they get the liquids out of the smeltery. You just put them on like this, and you're pretty much ready to go. Do you feel dumb for making that thing? By the way, you can see now it's lit up, that's because the structure is actually valid. And... bat? Where? I guess somewhere underneath here is a cave. But well, anyway, let's check how these are doing. We're almost done. So you're also going to, by the way, need two fosts to go along with those drains, because you can't get anything out but just drains. So, oh, here's where the casting table and casting basin come in. This is where you empty out in. You can't empty out in nothingness. You have to actually use casts and all. Yeah. Also, it will not use the second layer until it is closed. Keep that in mind. Like once I place those two bricks, then the space will be increased massively. Let's just show you. that's easier than explaining it. Now, I have all this space. Stop it, sheep. Stop! There are enough sheep in the neighborhood, I don't care. I have to still build this up so sheep can never climb in. Because I don't want it. Because you can actually get blood in it if any entity gets wounded from the hot liquid inside it. Yeah. Okay, but anyway, right now, it's actually still useless. These smelteries will not do a dang thing if they don't have anything heating them. For heating them, I'm gonna need lava. I don't wanna waste coal. I have enough coal. I actually left coal behind in the mine. There are like many coal ores, but I just didn't want to mine them up because my inventory was already getting full. Oh, by the way, I found a hay man from Witchery. It's pretty much a statue made out of hay. I mined it up and now I have bread. For days. Don't have to start farming too soon. So, yeah. So, what I wanted to make with this copper ingot is a hardened... No, a portable tank. It's not hardened yet. You can make it hardened, but I'm not done. I'm also gonna need a bucket, so I'm gonna smelt two more iron. And good thing there's still heat in that furnace. Because, of course, this can be used to transport liquids around easier. Because, of course, I don't want to run back and forth the whole time. So, just make a bucket like that, and I think I saw a lot of source in the distance, yeah. So you can actually pick these up very quickly if you use a wrench. You can also pick them up with a pickaxe. And I don't have a wrench yet, nor the materials for it, so I'm gonna go with that. Oh, copper. I actually don't have a lot of copper, so I'm just gonna take all the copper I can get. I only found two copper. It's not like I left anything behind. I just didn't find it. It looked weird when I came out of this angle. Thought I saw an R node. Well, if you want to know what an R node, what I mean with that, that's something from Tomcraft, which can be used to recharge wands. It is a very difficult to see if you're not using special lenses. I don't have any of these special lenses, so I thought I saw the vague thing you'll see when you look at one. I mean, at least when... Oh, there is. Yeah, you see, here, it's an arm node. If you punch it, it gets nice particles. Though it's ill-advised to break them, because... Well, you can't create them. You have to actually find them. You have to tap them. The only point in destroying it is to get ethereal essence, which you can also get from killing a wisp. Though I did break an R node. It was a sort of tainted one. Came out of an obsidian tile. Those can spawn furious zombies, so I tend to break them. Because furious zombies are pretty darn deadly. But okay, enough about zombies. It's time to fill up my smeltery. Just place down my tank and start filling it up. So this is going nice and easy. I can of course hold 4 buckets per, so a total 8 buckets of lava. Exactly the amount that fits into a portable tank. And now it's time to take some of the ores out. I think it doesn't fit more than a snack. It probably fits about 50. I believe it gets like one per spot on the inside, and well, yeah, of course 25 plus 25 is 50. Now you see this going up, and you see my lava going down. That's how the system pretty much works. It smelts the ores and doubles them, but at the cost of lava. And there's this strange thing where it cannot recognize my second seer tank, but if the first one runs out, then it will start using the second one. Don't worry. However, now that I've smelled my iron, I can only get it out as logs. I can't get it out as ingots. However, there's a fix for this. Let's first, however, just pull out block. So for this, I'll need special alloy. For alloys, I can... Okay, crafting. Jeez. I'm recording. Coming later. Okay. Wait, did I... I forgot to type recording, because I was trying to talk and type at the same time. It's my disability, okay? No, I really can't. Okay, stop crafting. Stop it. I'm recording, I just told you. Okay, so if we open this book up, there's a special section for L. Now you can see you can make bronze, aluminum brass, manulion, alamite, or pig iron. The one I want is aluminum brass. It will take 3 aluminum and 1 copper will form. Oh, I exactly have 3 aluminum and 1 copper. I'm not going to use the ground. So, aluminum brass can be used to make cast in a casting table. However, you need the shape of the objects you want to make the cast of. In this case, I want to make an ingot cast, so a brick will work. Also, this is the perfect example of this. You can see that the aluminum actually smelts a lot quicker than the iron. That is because different ores have different smelting points. Just like in real life, aluminum smelts at a lower temperature than copper, so it's done earlier. Now, this is, again, a strange bug. It's, instead of saying how many ingots there are, like with the iron, it is telling me how much millibuckets. Don't worry, though. I probably have enough for it. Now, I can pour out just ingots. I don't need to pour out anymore. I don't have to get 9 specifically just to get anything out. So let's just grab some more of my ores that actually have to go in the smeltery. No, most of these don't. And well, let's throw them in. Let's start with this. Actually, you have to mine something. Something's... Like, I've just done alloying. If I would have left the silver in there, it would have actually alloyed with gold to form something new. I don't think anything else will alloy right now. No, gold, lead doesn't alloy with anything, iron doesn't alloy with gold, and gold doesn't alloy with iron, of course. Okay, so I'm fine. So for right now, I'm going for 3 blocks, because I want to go explore that thing. Yeah. And that will be the end of this episode. That too. And like you see, nothing alloyed. But however, if I would have thrown in silver, I would have gotten an electrum. Oh, and by the way, this is plainly iron making ingots. Just pour them out, and here they are, copper ingots. I'm just... Yeah, okay. You know what, I'm gonna empty the smeltery myself right now, on my own. I'll see you guys later. Once I'm done. Okay, so I'm done emptying out the smeltery. I'm just gonna make armor real quick. I should empty my inventory. Let's see. I need. No, what? No, this will be my horse chest. For now, I'll probably later make it even further sorted. Okay, let's grab the iron. Oh, sorry. I've just been sitting strange, I guess. Okay. Let's just make my armor now. I don't know what I was trying to make. Oh, track remover, I guess. From Royal Craft. Huh. Like, I might want to bring an axe. Not a terrible axe, though. I like making things out of barret. It's pretty good material, and it's not used for anything else, so... yeah. Let's go. Let's go check out the weird thing and wrap up the episode then. Because I have no idea how long I've been busy. I am one of the guys that just doesn't keep a timer on hand. At least I forgot this time. Sometimes I do. Sometimes. That doesn't look like I'm putting a real dent. No, it's not harvestable. What is this weird thing? For some reason, there's dirt is on it. What is this? Like an ancient robot or something? This is called a colossal lag. I want to scale the top of this thing, possibly clean up the dirt. See what happens then. I can even... okay, let's just look it up, what colossal blocks can be. I always misspell colossal. Colossal mask can be used to make nothing, and it's not being craftable. None of the colossal blocks even... what, that's closed? I'm doubting any of them is useful for anything, so might as well leave it here, right? Just try, maybe if I clean it up and it starts moving or something. I probably need a factorization man to figure it out. Am I gonna also block that? Fracture? Possibly. Oh! Whoa! No! What happened? Just try and kill me? What are you? Doesn't seem like it wants to do jack shit. I'm gonna look this up. So I kinda can't figure anything out. I want to try and use this, but I don't have this. Exploded diamond block, dark iron, which is pain in the ass to get. I have to get so many things for this. I also need two music discs, which are going to take very long. Okay, no, I'm just gonna try looking online again. Okay, so I looked it up. It's apparently a minor boss from factorization. He won't move until I attack him again. Yeah. And it's advice. Oh! He has a tendency of disappearing when you're not looking at him right. Well, you know what? I'm trying to fight him. It's pretty weird having to break his blocks, apparently. It's not really. I want this. Crystalline dark iron. I think I should have first cleaned it off before I started it up. It's apparently a source for logic matrix programmers, which is a major part of factorization. Want to see her completely activating it? We'll get it to clean himself, because honestly, I don't want to. No! I got stuck on him. And I hate how he disappears the whole time. Okay, come on. I hate this as well. I'm guessing what's wrong is... Okay, crap. Okay, I'm almost off. Oh. I think the thing that's messing it up is the fact that it's supposed to fall further. Okay, maybe someone's going to beat me up. Chopping down a nearby tree so we can't get stuck on those anymore. Now it's just waiting for the leaves to decay. Which I am gonna help a bit, because I want them to fall over, finally. Nope, it will still not fall over. Start turning these into... planting stacking up. That's the thing, by the way, I want to have, is that fractured part again. Yeah, I might want to do that well today. I want to kill this thing just because it's big and ugly. And because it apparently drops fun stuff. At least important stuff. If I ever want to get started with factorization, I'm going to need it to die. So, yeah, I'm going to just do one attempt on him. I know that I have enough golden eggs. A decent pick, decent armor. And I don't believe he's too difficult, because it's for starting out with factorization that you have to kill him, and well, I'm just doubting that that kind of boss will be that difficult. The only difficult part is if he disappears from most of his body disappears, and then it will be difficult. I'm gonna try reloading the world, I'll be right back. Okay, that seems to have done the trick. Okay. Mine it! supposed to be able to be mined this. It somehow doesn't work correctly, and, well, this is the result, I guess, of it. Stop disappearing. Yeah, I'm supposed to be able to mine this. Well, that's too bad. I don't see where I see anything like it on the map, because I would want to kill one of those. Well, let me check. What is that? That could be one? I don't know. I don't remember what size he was on the map. But you know what? That will come at a later time then. At least, because you know what, this episode is about to, is should end now. Oops, that was minimalizing my screen. That was not a good idea. So guys, hope you enjoyed. Be sure to leave a like if you did, and if you know a way for me to like, yeah, attack this golem thing. Oh, yeah, blocks inside of him. If you know how to attack this thing, let me know, please, because I want to hurt him, actually. Make it fall. So difficult to tell whether or not, I'm digging underneath this thing. Because, well, his entire body has a tendency of disappearing. Okay, now, this doesn't make him fall, nothing will. Nothing will. So, see you all next time. Bye.